Course and stream is one of the very important topic in quantitative aptitude. So let's understand the concept and try to solve few of the problems which frequently comes in our exam. So the concept behind boats and stream is, in boats and stream, basically you'll have stream and boats. The stream is also called as river, or many places it will be also given as water, right? And there will be boat will be there. So river and boat will be moving either in the same direction or in the opposite direction. So there are the few terms which we have to keep in mind before solving the problem. So there will be one, speed of boat, speed of boat, or speed of man in still water. Okay, so the boat and man speed is nothing but the speed of boat only, because the man will be inside the boat, or man will be sitting on the boat, right? So speed of boat or speed of man in still water means when the water is not moving. So that time we assume it is u kilometer per hour, and this is the standard notation which we are going to use. If you'll see many books, R.S. Agarwal and in many other books, this is a standard notation which we use. Even you can assume it is x kilometer per hour, y kilometer per hour, whatever you want, right? Okay, then speed of river or speed of stream or speed of water. So in your question, all the three terms will be mentioned: river, stream, or water. So all those three things are exactly same. So this will be denoted as V. So speed of river, stream, and water is what? V kilometer per hour, right? Okay. And then there will be upstream and downstream. So let's understand what is upstream and downstream. So upstream will be denoted as B and downstream will be denoted as A. So again, this is a standard notation which we will be using across the boats and stream. Okay, so what is upstream and what is downstream? Many students will be confused in upstream and downstream. So let's understand it properly. So downstream is, so when the boat and the river or the stream is moving in the same direction. Downstream means when boat and river is moving in the same direction, right? Okay, so in that case, what will be your downstream speed? So suppose boat is moving right here, boat is there, boat is moving, and in the same direction a stream is moving. This is a stream. So what will happen? A stream will put force on boat and boat speed will increase, right? Because a stream is in the same direction, so a stream will put force on boat and boat will automatically move fast. So in case of downstream, when both are moving in the same direction, then the speed will get added, right? And we are able to see from here. So u plus v will be downstream speed. In upstream speed will be against. So boat will move against the stream or against the river. That means, suppose if boat is moving in this direction and a stream is moving in the opposite direction, then what will happen? A stream will put force on boat and the boat speed will automatically decrease. So which will be u minus v kilometer per hour. So upstream speed will be u minus v kilometer per hour, and downstream speed will be u plus v kilometer per hour. So this is two terms which you have to keep in mind. Okay, and then next will be a speed of boat. We can calculate using downstream and upstream. So speed of boat u will be 1 by 2 into upstream speed plus downstream speed. So 1 by 2 into what will be upstream speed? So upstream speed will be b, and downstream speed will be a. So 1 by 2 into a plus b will be nothing but a speed of boat, which you have to keep in mind. And now speed of river or speed of stream will be what? 1 by 2 into downstream speed minus upstream speed, which is nothing but 1 by 2 into a minus b. So these are the two formulas which you have to keep in mind while calculating a speed of stream, a speed of river, and a speed of boat. So this we can also write it 1 by 2 into a plus b. So a speed of boat, when upstream speed and downstream speed is given, it's equal to 1 by 2 into a plus b. speed of river or a stream, when the upstream speed or downstream speed is given, then 1 by 2 into a minus b, right? And downstream speed means both are moving in the same direction, then speed will get added, u plus v. And upstream speed means both are moving in the opposite direction, then the speed will be less, u minus v kilometer per hour. So let's solve one question. Question number 1, a man can row upstream at 7 km per hour. So upstream is given how much? 7 km per hour. Upstream we denote with b. Downstream at 10 km per hour. So downstream we denote at 10 km per hour. Right? Okay. What they are asking is find man's rate in still water. So man's rate is nothing but boat speed. Both are same only. Right? The speed of boat and the speed of man are same, which is nothing but 1 by 2 into a plus b when upstream and downstream speed is given, right? So 1 by 2 into 10 plus 7. So 1 by 2 into 17, which is nothing but 8.5 km per hour. This is what? This is nothing but my boat speed, right? So find man's rate in still water, that we found, and rate of current. And then they're asking a speed of current. So a speed of current when downstream and upstream is given, 1 by 2 into a minus b. So 1 by 2 into 10 minus 7, which is nothing but 3 by 2, which is nothing but 1.5 km per hour, right? So which option is true? So option B is the correct answer for this question.